Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of NPTEL, I would like to extend a very warm welcome to the principals, the SPOCs, the mentors, IIT directors, all the IITM faculty here, my colleagues, friends, and all the other representatives from various colleges who have gathered here. Good morning, sir. As we know, due to the incessant rains in Chennai, we had to reschedule this event to today. We are indeed very grateful to all of you who have accepted our invitation and found time amidst all your busy schedules to attend this event. We also appreciate the wonderful efforts put in by all the principals, the SPOCs, the mentors of each college for joining hands with us and making NPTEL Locals Chapter such a huge success. You are our strength. Local Chapter is our pilot initiative, and we are very excited to say that we now have 150 plus local chapters. More than 15 exam cities were included on requests from SPOCs. And we have also given out 3,500 plus scholarships to students so far. Some of the colleges who are represented today include Annai Velankanni College of Engineering, Dronacharya College of Engineering, Dronacharya Group of Institutions, Pullareddy Engineering College, K.S. Rangasamy College of Technology, Kalasingalam University, Kamaraj College, NEC Kovilpatti, Panimalar Engineering College, Panimalar Institute of Technology, Pratyusha Institute of Technology, Priyadarshini Engineering College, Rajalakshmi Engineering College, Saussure Academy of Engineering, Savita Engineering College, Setu Institute of Technology, Srimadi Kamala and Sri Venkappa Agadi College of Engineering, Sri Shasta Institute of Engineering and Technology, Sri Sharda College of Women, Sri Vasavi College, SSM Institute of Technology, Tyagaraja Polytechnic College, SRM, Kattangulathur, VHSN College, and Valliamma Engineering College. So we have representatives from all over Tamil Nadu, UP, Delhi, Karnool, etc. Now, speaking of NPTEL online courses, we are happy to share that from the time we initiated these courses till now, we have tripled the number of courses that we had run. Also, we have tripled the number of student registrations. None of this could have happened without your help. So I want to say a big thank you to all of you. And we hope to continue this work with you and ensure that online education reaches every student and every individual who has a thirst for knowledge. Thank you. Now, I would like to invite Professor Mangal Sundar sir to welcome our guests.
Good morning. Professor Bhaskar Rao Murthy, the director of IIT Madras and also chairman of the National Program Implementation Committee of NPTEL. Professor Andrew, Professor Pradap, who are the next coordinators for several years of NPTEL, and I hope that they will take it through this and many, many other initiatives of NPTEL. My faculty colleagues from several departments here, and the faculty and principal and administrative staff from all the institutions who are adopting NPTEL in one form or the other to improve their own educational needs, as well as to tell us how to create better and more directly useful learning materials to the students. The entire NPTEL staff team, led by three or four people to start with, Mr. Kannan, Krishnamurthy, Bharti, and Deepa, and of course Kamala, who was here, and all the other staff members. So it is my pleasure to welcome you all as an outgoing NPTEL coordinator. I've been associated with this project for the last 12 years from the beginning, but I'm extremely happy that the next team of the colleagues and interactive groups like yours is forming so much more directly, and we wish you a very, very pleasant online learning as well as offline learning. Online learning is only for a short period. It's an event, and we follow the model of MOOCs. So it is my pleasure on behalf of the entire NPTEL team and to the chairman of the NPTEL to welcome you to this one-day event, which will help us to interact with you face-to-face and also solve some of the issues which have surfaced in the last several months to a year in interacting with colleges. NPTEL is offered unconditionally, as you know, but of course a certificate is a service, and therefore it does cost the process if we have to make the certificate a proctored form. This follows very closely the massive open online course format, except for the certification part, which is proctored seriously by the NPTEL body, because this was discussed many, several times in our PIC, and the chairman was kind enough to allow this process of proctoring with the private body, which will run the online examination to a certification level. Therefore, we hope that the certificate that is generated is also very credible, besides all the learning that happens during the process of the online course. The courses will be offered several times. During the whole day, we would like to have interaction with all of you to take this project further, and also to bring in thousands of other NPTEL local chapters throughout the country, and some probably many outside this country as well. And we hope that as a family, it grows very large, very fast, but not without control, that it keeps the quality. And NPTEL is also leading the way for the entire national MOOCs movement, which are now carried out by many other institutions. Therefore, we have a lot to learn from all of you. Let me welcome all of you on behalf of the team, and we hope that you have a wonderful day. Thank you very much.
Very good morning to all of you, and welcome to IIT Madras for this meeting of local chapters of the NPTEL online course program. The NPTEL program started as a massive initiative to use the then fairly new medium of online repository in the early 2000, that period, to make available to students across India, but even across the world, whomsoever may be interested, as we say in our letters, no, to whomsoever it may concern. A whole lot of courses, course material, which are prepared by faculty who are among the best available in the country in various disciplines. Actually, if you do a analysis of the program, which has been running for almost, I think, 10 years now, you'll find that its cost-benefit ratio is very good. There's no way any other country with their cost structures could have done created a repository of this kind for the amount of money that was spent. It's also been used quite well, though it is sort of like publishing a book and putting it out. We don't know who's using it, we don't know what they are using it for, but we know through feedback when we meet people who have used it that it has served the purpose in many ways for different people. One of the things it did also, collateral benefit, was that because it takes a fairly large organizational effort to run, create such a repository, the NPTEL project, from the point of view of those who create the courses, you know, the IIT faculty, the IISc faculty, many other institutions who joined in as partners in small ways, it helped create a large family of faculty members who have similar focus and a similar mission. So a very large number of people across institutions who share some common interests and who share some common goals have become friends, come to know each other, have also seen each other's work on online, because you can always go and look up anybody's course, and you have a feeling of being part of a common team that is trying to do something. This also is very important in a large country like ours. Very often, otherwise, we are just working by ourselves. When this new mass MOOC format started evolving in the West, as a way of a more interactive way of using the online medium for education compared to just putting an online course as a repository, we also started looking at it. Some small number of faculty actually offered courses on global MOOC platforms, and we also started thinking about discussing among ourselves. That's where that formation of this large family helped. You know, how, in what way can it be useful in our country, in our ecosystem, in our situation? How should we adapt it? What should we do? So the various ideas that came up, the various ideas they still keep coming up. We are still learning. There's a long way to go. Partly our interactions with you, we are seeking to find out what works, what doesn't work, and so on. And we said we should also start experimenting, because only then we'll know. Simply standing outside the pool, touching the water with the toe is not going to help. No, you have to get in. So even though the NPTEL project as it existed in the previous phase, which just concluded this month, is concluding actually on December 31st, did not include a MOOC component, we have enough flexibility and we have running the program sufficiently efficiently that we had enough funds left over. So we said, let's try this, let's learn. So that when we submit the next phase for NPTEL for funding, we have a very clear idea of what can be done and what will work. And we can promise something which we are confident of delivering, not in a fully experimental mode. So we started a couple of years back with the help of Google's open source platform. We started offering some MOOCs courses, and that is how this NPTEL online program, online courseware started. And whoever faculty were excited about trying this, we roped them in and we started. We also felt that from our discussions, which I mentioned, we also felt that we must, have a certification component, otherwise it doesn't make sense. And we started from pretty early in the game. I don't think we offered any course without certification, or we might have one or two, but not too many. And we said we must do this. And that's how, there are some MOOCs programs in the world which do this, but many don't. And as we started, we realized also that in the Indian context, a large fraction of the potential user base are young students who are in college. This profile is very different in other countries. Many other countries, these are targeted at working people, at people who are otherwise in other professions or maybe not even employed, just wanting to learn, in a more of a continuing education kind of mode. And whereas we realize that we are actually going to be having a very large number of users who are young and for whom this is their, they are in the graduate education program, and this is something to augment what they are already going through. So we realize that even the mode in which these courses are consumed, if to use a modern word of in the online world, by users may be very different. It might be done more in groups. Even their entire classes may do it. There may be a mentor or a teacher who is involved also, which is very, very unusual. If you ask a MOOC program coordinator or somebody who is running, even conceived of MOOCs in the US, they would not imagine that the users will be sitting in groups, and large number of them may even have a teacher with them. So these are all things that are unique to us, and we should therefore think about how to use the MOOC in this context and get the maximum out of it, with no preconceived notions about what should be done, what should not be done, and so on. So I think we started feeling our way forward, and that is how the formation of these local chapters have happened. We realized that many of the users, our students, are in colleges, and there are teachers with them, and they can be of immense, they can be actually a partner in this. And I think the NPTEL coordinators who are looking to see what will work best, I found that this local chapter formation is very useful, and they've encouraged it, and lo and behold, we now have, as they say, 150 odd local chapters, and we have variety of experiences from these local chapters. Different chapters have tried different things. Some of them have worked very well, so we can now transfer best practices from one to the other. We even have one local chapter, as Andrew was telling me, in Ecuador. And we have several across the country. Of course, large number are in Tamil Nadu because of physical proximity. The NPTEL online course courses are being taught by faculty from all over India, but a larger fraction of are from IIT Madras. And since the head, sort of the coordination of NPTEL is done from Chennai, from IIT Madras, the initial effort is also, a large fraction of it is from here. So there are a lot of Tamil Nadu colleges. But what we now see is we've just got approval for the next phase of NPTEL program. And the next phase of NPTEL program is largely going to be online courses. I don't know if there's any, but there might be some continuing development of repository. We may or may not, I'm not, I'll find out. But the focus is largely on these online courses, and we actually want to figure out and expand in a way in which we end up being a force multiplier, as they call in military. We already have in India a large number of colleges. The colleges have teachers, they have students, large numbers are learning. All these institutions have grown very rapidly in the last 15, 20 years. In fact, most of them in the last 10 years. When you have rapid growth, there are always gaps. There are not enough teachers, not enough infrastructure, whatever, right? Students from different backgrounds come to these places. They come with various handicaps as a result. And everybody has to scramble to fill up these gaps. What we want to do is to see how the NPTEL online course program can become a force multiplier in that effort. So IIT, the faculty of the IITs, IISc, or if tomorrow even some of the faculty of these institutions, engineering institutions, who are in a position to actually, who are in a strong position and in a position to therefore reach out and be a force multiplier. These, we are trying to see how, given their limited time and bandwidth, because they're all anyway already also functioning in the normal, you know, good old, brick and mortar method of teaching and grading and research and all of that. They're all doing all that. So how can they function in a way in which this kind of technology, this kind of tool can be used to really increase the value proposition dramatically for the students across the country? As we saw from some of the feedback from the students who are giving their anecdotal views on this in the small video that you saw, it can mean lots of things to lots of people. Some people just are getting very excited by the quality of the teaching. Some people like the content. Some people like the breadth, you know, learning something about appreciating music, whatever. The point is, how can we enable using this? How can some limited amount of quality, high quality, and solid effort, but limited in scale, because the number of people and the amount of time they can spend on this is limited. How can that be amplified to some extent by this kind of technology and really made available to large number of people with the, this is an amplifier that whose performance depends on the impedance matching with the receivers, which means the local chapters are very, very important. Okay. So I think you will hear more from my colleagues on this, but we are really looking forward to learning from you how the local chapters can play a big role in the oncoming years as we expand this program. Then the MHRD is in the process of creating a very large single platform for online courses in the country. It is called Swayam. It will come into existence soon. I think the processes are going on. So it's not very different from what you are having now, except that it will be nationwide and it will involve courses offered not just by the IITs and IISc through this NPTEL, but also involve courses offered by other universities, other institutions in law, medicine, in sciences, in humanities, and so on. So Swayam will be a very large nationwide program. And what we are hoping is all our learnings from this effort will help us develop that into a really solid program, which can be unique in the world. First, it solves our problems, then maybe it will help solve problems for some others also. This is our hope, and I hope, and you as the early 150 chapters involved in this, whatever you are learning, whatever you are sharing with us, whatever you are contributing as your inputs to what will make this work better, it's going to matter a whole lot to everybody in the country, not just for these courses and these chapters. So I think we actually think, as we are seeing what's happening, that there can be a huge role played by people across the country who may be consumers but may also become contributors partly. We can have situations where students or other faculty members who are in different parts of the country contribute various solutions to problems, small expositions on the way they are able to explain something, which is very good. So this can actually be augmented very well, and we think a lot is possible. The other things that we worked out once the certification is being done, we want to make sure that credits can be obtained. You know that UGC is, you know, all universities are moving to a choice-based credit system. So that has to come in place. Then there has to be a mechanism for credits to be transferred. MHRD is working on all of that. But in the meantime, of course, some of you are already doing it. But this is going to become a common possibility for all students in the country. And as we move towards that kind of a system, by the time we are ready to put all those nuts and bolts in place, we must know what aspects of this new online technology, you know, this MOOC technology works for us in what way, in what fashion, in, you know, because we don't want to run something which doesn't do a good job and, you know, which leaves, which sort of, you know, says one more sort of a half-baked attempt at trying to expand education. We don't want that kind of situation. We want a situation where we have grasped this new tool properly and used it well and really used it to make a difference to the quality and scale of our huge educational expansion. So I thank you all for coming today. Though we had to reschedule because of the rains, I hope there were rains all over Tamil Nadu. So those of you who are from Tamil Nadu in your respective areas, I hope things have come back to normal. And I request you all to share your views and learn from each other and help us learn from you what works and what doesn't work, so that the next phase of the NPTEL, when you see hundreds of these courses being offered continuously across the country, that large numbers of students can benefit and we can learn and we can really grow this in a matter of couple of 2-3 years to a really solid program, which is a force multiplier for the huge education system that is growing and evolving in our country. Thank you very much.
Okay, good morning everyone. Thanks for coming once again. This program was rescheduled and thanks for being able to make it. So I have a brief presentation that goes over the numbers. I think sometimes each of us do our own individual thing. It's good to see the consolidated numbers of what online certification has done so far, etc., etc. I'll start with that and then I'll talk about local chapters and how NPTEL has already benefited from local chapters and how we think of taking it forward in the future. So that's what I'm going to do. I'll quickly go through the slides. I have several colleagues with me who are also going to share their experiences. Some of them have taught courses with us and interacted with you, hopefully. So they'll also talk about it. So, all right. So these are some numbers. NPTEL, like Professor Bhaskar and Mangal mentioned, it's been around for 12 years. Professor Mangal was very humble in the way he said it, but NPTEL has been a big phenomenon. And there's no doubt about it. For the money that we spent and for the effort that he has put in, he has achieved tremendous results, and these are the numbers, and they don't—they tell the complete story the way it has to be. And these kind of numbers you won't find in many portals, and also you have to keep in mind, NPTEL doesn't go for the hot, glamorous sort of courses. You know, I mean, we go for hardcore engineering courses. We're here to solve the problems of engineering colleges and university systems in the country. So we're focused on that, and to rake up these kind of numbers is really, really impressive. And a lot of credit goes to Professor Mangal Sundar, and I think we should all clap our hands once. Technology is a tremendous effort, and like Professor Bhaskar mentioned, bringing people in together and holding them together, that's one of his huge strengths, and he's able to do that, and he has done it for so many years. So it's all due to him. Okay, so NPTEL online certification, like most of you know, has three steps. I think I'm going to quickly go through this. There's this open online course, which is run along the lines of MOOCs on the portal, and then we have the proctored exam, following which you get a certificate. So this is the sequence, and we found it to be quite a good model for many people, keeping the open online course entirely free so that you can do just learning if you like. And then if you feel like writing the exam, you can pay a fee and write that. So this is the story so far in terms of numbers, and that's the portal. It's got a new look now, and we're trying to change it because once you have hundreds of courses, it's difficult to have it all on the same page, and it's very hard to look. So we're trying to work with the engineers at Google. And of course, I have to acknowledge the contribution of Google. They've contributed in time and effort and actual hardware resources. I think close to $1 million now if you add up everything in 2 years, and that's a lot of money they put in, and it's most of it is due to their effort as well. In January 2016, we have 45 courses, Natures and Networks and Systems, which were redone, repurposed to be used in a MOOC. And assessments are multiple choice, you have a discussion forum, a lot of questions asked, and like it was mentioned in that little video, we also have hands-on programming. In fact, even subjective assignments are possible. We have faculty members who ask you to submit PDF documents which are manually graded, etc. So that's also possible. And mentors, okay, so we have a certification partner who runs exams. I think many of you are also TCSI on certified exam centers, I think, right? Many of your colleges are also that. So you would have seen these kind of exams. And the certificate right now comes from the continuing education centers of IITs. And in future, like Professor Bhaskar mentioned, there might be a way to have a different body issuing those kind of things. Introduction to Research, which Professor Pratap Haridas is coordinating, that's a very different sort of course, not like a regular classroom course. It has group discussions. Okay. It's really go beyond everything. So in fact, January 2016, there's a course on how to use a scanning electron microscope. Now, that's an important skill, and apparently it's not that difficult. It can be taught very nicely and you can use it. In fact, the faculty member says, anyone who does my course can go and take measurements in an SEM directly without any problem. So one more course is coming up in July, which is again interesting, is three or four faculty members together are putting together a course on what is the career or how different career options and how to choose career options. A very innovative sort of course, as in they're going to go into industry, 10 years experienced people, talk to them about how their career took shape. Courses which don't have too many takers are supported by the courses which have huge takers. So overall, we achieve a nice balance. And for instance, civil engineering is a subject that a lot of people like good electives in, and we are trying very hard to make sure that disciplines like civil engineering, mechanical engineering, we do offer enough electives and core courses to help the need there. Okay, and the institutes right now, IIT Madras and Kanpur are playing a big role. We've also had contributions from smaller institutes like CMI and Math Science. Professor Madhavan is here, hopefully he'll talk a little bit more. And other institutes are jumping into it. Kharagpur is offering 8 courses in January. This is their starting point, and the way I see it, they are very serious. They're going to offer more courses. We are going to get Delhi also. We were at Delhi on 15th. The faculty that are really excited, they're going to offer courses. Hopefully IISc and other IITs will also jump in. Once all of them come in, like Professor Bhaskar mentioned, number is going to be hundreds of courses every semester. And now that is a different sort of problem. You know, how do you pick what course to take? How do you advise students on which is interesting, etc., etc.? So we hope to work with you and help you in that process as well. Okay, so here is a list of course titles just to capture the length and breadth of the kind of courses we offer. Not just going for interesting ones, all over the place, everything you want to imagine is out there. And I'm enrolled in courses, and 15,000 students have got certificates so far. And that's the big number. Of course, enrollment is always very big, and the number of people who do certificates is lesser, and that's to be expected. I mean, no, you don't put any filter at the beginning. You admit anybody you want enrolls. And then you say you have to learn suddenly, you know, programming and data structures. Not everybody is tuned to that. They don't know it also. And after the second week only, they'll know, okay, this course is not for me. Maybe in some countries, they expect results in this fashion. But I think in our country, it perfectly makes sense. I mean, you can be in any discipline. You can do courses in any other discipline. If you don't like it, you drop out. I think that's a much more liberal way of learning than, you know, going into one discipline, whether you like it or not, doing everything in that only. I mean, I think that's not the correct philosophy. So in fact, I like this number. From what other portals might see. But that's not the only thing. About 13% are employed. So the significant number is also employed in work, and 7% are others. Others meaning various people. And when we go to exams, we see, I mean, it's quite interesting. There's a IG from CRPF, even the January run. IIT Kanpur is also getting into it. They're also trying to push that big time in their state. So West Bengal will also come up as Kharagpur comes up. So other states will slowly jump into this as well. Some testimonials from students. You heard quite a bit on the video that I think is a very good testimonial. So in fact, there's a college called Amini College of Engineering in Palakkad, which about 75 students from there have got certificates. And they made a nice video where each student comes on the video and explains for like 2 minutes or something what they got out of it. So that's something that I would encourage all the local chapters to make. I mean, if you can make a video like that with your students, it'd be very nice. Okay. Also, a couple of things we do to bring students into prominence. Students spread out all over the country. We don't know who the good ones are. So we have a toppers page on our portal where for every course, anyone who got more than 90, their little photograph and the college name and the score is mentioned in the toppers page. And it's so heartening for me to see, for instance, in the programming data structures course, programming in C course, I think a couple of students from Kamaraj College of Engineering. Do we have representatives from Kamaraj? Yeah. So a couple of students from there, their face and name comes up. I grew up in Trichy, so someone far away from the big cities to see their face in a big portal saying, okay, I'm one of the toppers in this course. I don't know, the kind of confidence that student would get is tremendous. It's nice to see that kind of thing from spread out from all over the country. I mean, of course, all the colleges are also mentioned. I was personally happy about that. But, you know, so many nice things come out when you have something like this. And this is a nice thing that I think our staff came up with this idea of putting up toppers on the webpage. I think it's a very nice thing as well. So every student has a profile on that page. Okay, so the profile shows for every student what are all the courses they did, how well they did in that course, what marks they got, what exam marks, everything. So the student has a record or transcript of how they did the course in the portal available always. Not only the student, anyone who wants to verify also can do the same thing. So it's a nice setup in that fashion. Okay, so in terms of numbers, once again, the enrollment is always very big, but the number of people who submit the first homework, in my opinion, is a good representation of people who think they can do this course. And from that number, you can count your dropout. I think that's a more reasonable measure, at least as far as I'm concerned. And we have seen in many courses where local chapters were involved and the mentors interacted with the student, the number of people who submitted the first homework, they stayed on till the end. So I think that again brings out the importance of colleges supporting students doing these courses. It goes a long way in retaining them, helping them be disciplined about the course. Because the discipline part, the regularity part is something that you can't enforce on an online portal. So it has to be done from the colleges. I think it makes a big difference in that fashion. Okay, so this is some list of courses. We'll go through this in maybe detail a little bit later. So I want to say a few things about what we learned. So I think Professor Bhaskar was mentioning general things. And there are a few specific things we have learned from local chapters already, and we are trying to enforce them into our system. Okay. So one problem we've had is in IIT, when we run a course, we are supposed to declare the method of grading and stick to it. But usually there's a lot of flexibility in that. You know, I mean, that's how I'm used to running a course here. I can say, okay, halfway through the course, I find, you know, the first exam didn't really work. I'll reduce the percentage for that. You know, things like that. It's very flexible here because we have a small group of students and we have the liberty to assess the class on its own, because I mean, that's how our university works. And many faculty keep that flexibility in their mind even for online courses. So we had a few mishaps because of that. That was invaluable feedback once again. So now we're really pushing our faculty to declare a clear scheme of evaluation and stick to it whatever happens till the end. So that's a huge learning we had, that we had to push that into faculty's minds when they're ready to offer the course. That's one issue we had. The other great important issue was, actually, I was in Kurnool for an exam, and a few students from I think Pullareddy College is representative here as well. They were coming out and was talking to them about how the course went, etc. They said, we all did assignments. We used to just take assignments from others and put it in. I asked them, don't you have lectures? Why are you not able to do the assignment based on the lectures? And the student, I still remember the way she said it. She said, the lectures don't show how to solve the assignment. And I was really a bit puzzled by it, because for me, the lectures are talking about how to use, you know, for loop. It was a programming course, how to use for loop, how to use while loop, what's how to declare array, etc. Lectures are talking about it, but the program is asking them to solve some last ant on a rod problem. Okay, so for many students in IIT, or even people like me, we're used to students who don't need that kind of hand holding. So they know how to solve problems. So you put a problem, they know how to solve it. They've been solving problems from a very young age. They know how to solve problems. So when you describe some scheme, they know how to translate their problem in that language. They know how to do that. So you have to just describe that to them. You know, so when we describe in the lecture, okay, this is how you do it, and then you give any other problem, they'll know how to do that translation. So our faculty are used to such kind of teaching. So they don't do that last mile of working out problems in detail for students in class. In fact, you do that, our students will get bored. They won't even come to those classes. So they're used to that kind of a setup. So this was great feedback. Once again, so we are passing on that feedback back to faculty now. So we're telling them that every week you have to have one lecture which actually works out problems. So if it's a programming course, you have a video where you're sitting in front of a computer typing a program, you know, debugging, compiling, everything. You show literally how you do it. So these are things that we are passing on to faculty now, getting them to do those kind of things. In fact, come up with solutions for assignments. Quite often, you know, when we give tutorial problems in class here, we don't have to put out solutions. Well, there's a group of students who solve it, they already have solutions with them. So you really don't have to do that. But we're insisting on solutions, etc. So we're slowly trying to use this kind of feedback. And I want to take this opportunity to say, we really want more feedback from you. Okay, so really what worked? It can be anything. What worked, what didn't work, any problem you had. We don't guarantee that we can fix it, because ultimately this entire system relies on academic freedom given to faculty in running courses. We won't overly disturb that. But nevertheless, the feedback is important in giving guidelines. And we can give guidelines to faculty. Of course, we can give guidelines to faculty saying, this is what works well. In our experience, this works well. Please use it. And that's good enough. In most cases, faculty will follow it. They know, they understand that their ultimate target is, of course, to educate people. Right? They're not trying to fight anybody here. So this feedback is very important. And quite often I've seen many of you are a little bit reluctant to give feedback. I mean, our staff are quite friendly. You've seen them, you've interacted with them. So if you think you're a little bit, you don't want to tell me anything, you can definitely tell them. And they'll also pass it on to us. And sometimes, you know, our culture is such that you don't really question the teacher too much. You know, if you don't, you don't feel like questioning teachers, you can all, you can tell them that many of them are available out here. So please use this opportunity to give us good constructive feedback and how to make things better. Okay, so of course getting marks is important, but like I said, the wider thing of what to do to help your students learn better, I think that's at the heart of it. Please take this opportunity to do so. Okay, so I'm done as far as the presentation is concerned. I think we have some time budgeted for others to talk. So
thank you, sir. Next, I'd like to invite Professor Pratap Hedas to talk about local chapters.
Good morning. I join Andrew, Professor Bhaskar Ramurthy, and Professor Mangal. And first of all, thanking you all for joining us today. NPTEL has been a learning experience for us. It still is a learning experience, and I expect it will remain that way. I mean, there are courses we teach, but this process is itself new. So there are many things that is a learning experience for us, that are learning experiences that we are using along the way. So whatever it is that we have accomplished so far is something that's an evolving process. So we have got some, you know, procedures in place, some method of doing things and so on. But these are all things that have evolved over the last year and a half, especially with respect to these online courses. And we are actually, you know, continuously looking to see if we are headed in the right direction, if there are things that we can do to improve the experience of this online course initiative for all the students who participate in it and all the faculty who are interested in it. So as we started out, initially the audience was typically, you know, individuals spread across the country. In many ways that is nice because it means that, you know, you can have two people in, you know, Delhi, one person in Karnool, five people in, you know, Assam, who are interested in a course, and we still offer the course and people benefit from it. So really this is an inverted model. We have come to many of your colleges, experienced your hospitality and shared many of our experiences with you. The model is inverted because in general in India, we have always had the situation that, you know, 100,000 people want to get into a college, there are only 1,000 seats. So the first and most important job of the college is to figure out a way to eliminate 99,000 people. Then you work with the 1,000 people. So the most, you become most famous for that process by which you have eliminated 99,000 people. This is an inverted model. We don't really mind, if 100,000 people are interested in a course, they can take the course. There's no problem, they can take it. And so that, as Andrew uses the word, it's very liberating. You can take whatever you wish. It is really education the way we have always wanted it to be. That is, people are interested in something, they try it out. They are not denied the opportunity of even trying out what they are interested in. They try it out. Maybe after, you know, three classes, they feel that, yeah, in fact, I thought it was my line of work, but it is not. I'm not quite comfortable with it. So you pull out. And so that contributes to those dropout numbers. They just join, check it out, see if it, you know, it's really as interesting as they thought it was, or they really connect with it the way they felt it they would. And if they don't, they pull out, which is wonderful. I mean, in fact, so now you really have even a liberated individual. He or she knows that, you know, okay, I won't live my life thinking I never got an opportunity to try this course. I tried it, and then of the five things that I thought I was interested in, it turns out I'm only interested in one of them. Great. So then they can really, you know, focus with all their heart on that one thing, without having this, you know, always this feeling that, you know, I was not allowed to look at this stuff. And that's really the case here, because you can be a civil engineering student, you can take an electrical engineering course, you can take chemistry course, you can take computer science course, anything you can take, aerospace course, you can, nobody, we are not stopping anybody. If they do well, they do well, they get a certificate from us. So that's the thing. So as I said, you know, initially we started off with individuals. Now we were also looking at new ways to, you know, make sure that more students benefit from this whole process. A lot of effort is being put in and interest is there. We just wanted to make those two connect. And the local chapter process has really helped this happen. And so, first of all, we really thank all of you for, you know, having enabled it, because of local chapters, we really have a much more coordinated way in which we are able to reach out to students, understand their concerns, understand any limitations in the process, and address them. So just to give you a few examples, some have already been mentioned. I think Pullareddy College is here. We had 500 candidates from that college participate in one course. So specifically for them, examination centers were opened. So this is something that we understood. Our exam partner enables these things. If there are a large number of collection of students in one location, we can add more exam centers in that location. Knowing this ahead of time really helps so that we can plan our logistics much better. So that we had about 500 students, and we had centers in Kurnool specifically for them. In a mini college in Palakkad, we have 100 plus students who wrote exams, and at that point they didn't even have a local chapter, so that was very nice. Then we also, again, learning experience, you know, sitting in a city, we assume certain things and they are not necessarily true. So for example, with respect to Annai Velangani College, what we learned was that, you know, many students may not have online payment processes available to them through which they can make, you know, we just set up a portal, we say you pay your fees online and so on. And that may not work. And the college authorities were very helpful. They worked with the students. I think they are here. I think Annai Velangani College is here. Yeah, so great. So that's them. They really worked with those students, tried to enable payment of those fees in a coordinated way through DD and so on. And so that worked. And we've had a lot of other things that are going on side by side. Throughout the country, there are, you know, people are certainly looking at this idea that such online courses can be used for credit in some manner that is acceptable to their university. As Professor Bhaskar Ramamurthy was pointing out, the government also wants to expand this program and have something called SWAYAM, which is expected to come sometime soon, presumably more actively get colleges to benefit from this in a formal way. Right now it's going on, we give a certificate, the student takes it, and he or she can use it where they see fit. This would make it much more formal. Already many universities are doing this in some manner. So for example, in Madanapalli College in Andhra Pradesh, one online course is compulsory for all engineering students, 3 credits. So any one course they can take, and 3 credits worth of content is there. Then they clear the course successfully, then they get credits for it. This kind of a model is actually being tried out by different universities within the flexibility that is there in their system. So they are asking for one or more courses to be taken by their students, and an NPTEL course ideally fits that kind of a requirement. In Maharashtra University also, students have been allowed to take one online course for credit. Many students from Pune are taking this kind of courses from us. UPTU has mandated all colleges to take NPTEL open online courses, and about 25 have joined with local chapters. So this kind of initiative is on, and I expect it's very likely that it will grow, that one or more courses would be specifically picked up by students. And there again, I think local chapter really helps in helping us decide what is that course that would make sense. Our faculty right now are offering courses based on their expertise, their knowledge, domain knowledge, what they feel students in that area should, it's important for students in that area to learn. Specific colleges may be looking for a particular elective where they may not have faculty. So that kind of a feedback helps us also plan our courses, to tell our faculty that, you know, certain types of courses people are looking for and so on. Even the new course that we are offering, the one that's coming up on research methodology, and to some degree it is based on feedback. We also had the idea that it would be a useful course, but we did have specific written feedback from a number of students saying that, you know, this kind of a thing is not there. We are joined for some research degree and we are not really sure what we need to do. So we have now, you know, that kind of feedback helps us put such a course together. We already have such courses in our campus, but we had not thought of it as something that we could offer as an online course. Now we're going to do that. So in any case, I think that's all I really wanted to share with you. We really thank you for being, actively being local chapters in your respective colleges. It's a very important, concept and, activity for making this whole, community activity of education successful. So I thank you all for being that, and I thank you for having come here. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.